what we're going through now as a country, in particular in higher education, I like to draw an example from the health science field or health faculty. And we see that it's a very good example to draw from, because if you look at them, they are constantly engaged in their field. If they're not in the hospital, they're in the classroom. If they're not in the classroom, they're studying. If they're not studying, they're doing community work. So in a similar fashion, we try to use these approaches in terms of engaging students within our classrooms. So if they're not in the classroom, they're doing online training in some sort of free or open source software. If they're not doing that, we find for them open source material to read. If they're not busy with that, there's practicals. If there's not that, there's some sort of online course. If that isn't available, we pull people from outside industry, be it professionals or guys from other academic institutions or research facilities. Even our very own postgraduate students come in and show our undergraduates what they're doing, the tools they're using, the skills they developed, and pass this on. So I like to think of the philosophy of each one teach one, and that sort of fits the whole teaching and learning ideology within the classroom and the way I teach in general.
What he did was teach us more of what we have to deal with out there than just making education like a system, like you learn what this rock is and that's now. He taught us something that we're gonna do out there.
My teaching philosophy comes from a sort of a, yes, it's maybe a bit tenacious and sort of cutthroat to a certain extent, but I come from a perspective of come ready to work. In a sense that, and this is where this whole medical fraternity ideology comes from for me, because I have family that are doctors and dentists and so forth, and I see how hard they have to work to get where they want to be and to be successful. And taking that ideology and putting it into earth sciences in general.
He basically teaches you how to learn. He'll quote the book, the title, the author, and the publication year. And he'll give you the chapter sometimes as well. And you'll go read it. And then you'll read, prep. If there's something you don't understand, come the next day and he'll clarify. And it's almost like it's a cycle. And that basically has taught me how to teach myself.
From a blended learning perspective, I feel that technology plays an important role, but there's also other factors that come into play. So what I do is, now I'll maybe outline for you a typical lesson plan, and this can give you some context or idea of how I apply blended learning in the classroom. So what we do is, before the student even comes into the classroom, we would have them read a chapter in a book and some notes, and that's generally open source. And they would also watch videos, which either I have recorded based on my material and the material in the notes in the book, or that they have found on the internet somewhere, which is also open source or under Creative Commons license of some sort. The student then comes into the classroom. We have a discussion with regards to the subject matter. I run through some defining principles, and we look at it for a period maybe not longer than 20 minutes. So it's more a discussion than it is a taught lesson. There afterwards, because now they've obviously interacted with the technology and they have a background in what they need to know and the knowledge base, we possibly look at case studies as well. After the classroom, students are randomly selected to be tested one-on-one. And I feel this is where the humanizing pedagogy aspect comes in for me personally, because while you're testing that student, you get to know them as well, you understand their weaknesses, what are their strengths, but you also having a discussion with them one-on-one about what they want out of life. The relationship with the students is a very open one, as much as we can, because of the fact that we try to be as flexible to the students' needs without compromising the quality and delivery of the course.
He's very approachable, so you don't see him as this figure that you are afraid of, like you don't want to ask him questions, you don't want to laugh in front of him, or you don't want to be yourself in front of him. I won't say he's a friend, because you still need to have respect for your lecturers at the end of the day, but he is approachable.